Today we are getting very bougie with a full face of Gucci. I enjoyed the Gucci foundation so much that I ended up buying two Gucci belts. How those two things are related, I still am not sure, but in my mind at 2 a.m. online shopping, it made sense. So I decided I wanted to try the rest of their line, and you guys, I really, really love how this look turned out. If your makeup routine is your favorite ritual, be sure to hit that subscribe button because I am here 3 times a week sharing my beauty habit with you. Let's dive in. I already have on moisturizer and sunscreen, and we're going to start with the Gucci Serum Debuté. This is their Silk Priming Serum. Gucci packaging is just nice. They have done such a good job with this line. I love the frosted glass. It has so much weight to it, and I am a sucker for good luxury packaging. I really like this. It glides over the skin. It feels quite silky, but there's just a teensy bit of grip there that I feel might be really good for a primer. We are going to be using the Gucci Fluid Debuté. This is their Natural Finish Fluid Foundation today. I wear the shade 120N. I have an entire review on this foundation if you'd like to see it. I have tried this before and was so impressed with it. Since I know I like the foundation, that makes it a little bit easier for me to tell if I like the primer or not. Half of my face is done. It's a very nice foundation. It spreads out, blends in really beautifully. I like buffing it in with like a rounded foundation brush. It looks so nice on the skin. It gives you a really natural skin finish. It's medium coverage. You can definitely build it up. I would say anywhere from like the lighter side of medium up to like a more full medium, and it does build up really nicely. Again, big fan of this foundation. I think it is actually really nice. And the first two products that we tried here today, the primer and this foundation, I will say both of them have fragrance, but I do find it to be a little bit lighter than Chanel fragrance and much lighter than Dior fragrance. So for me, it has not bothered my skin. Anything that I've tried from this line, it's not bothered my skin, but if you are super sensitive, it's something to watch out for. There are a few products that Gucci is missing from their line. They don't have any eyeshadows yet. They don't have blush. I think I can work with the products they do have. The one thing I cannot get around that they do not yet have is concealer. So I'm going to quickly apply my favorite concealer. It's the NARS Radiant Creamy Concealer. I wear the shade Chantilly. I'm gonna go ahead and set my under eyes using the beauty powder in number 00. Shout out to Gucci for this packaging because it's just so freaking nice. They give you a little powder puff, so I think I might try to set my under eyes with the powder puff. I just want to see if I end up liking it or not. I'm only setting under my eyes because for blush, we're gonna try to work with a lipstick. I often will only use powder on my under eyes to set my concealer, and then at the very end, I will go in and touch with powder where I kind of want to mat the skin down a little bit. I like to leave that step for like almost the very last so I can make sure that my look is very balanced. The shade looks like a really good match, and I'm gonna use a little bit of it on my lids. Before we do anything with eyeshadow, let's go ahead and do brows. This is the Powder Eyebrow Pencil. I got the shade Taupe. It is just a regular pencil. It did come with its own little Gucci sharpener. Very fancy. It has a spoolie on one end and then just a classic pencil on the other end. You guys, no matter what I do, this brow is always much better than this brow. It's sad. This is a really good classic eyebrow pencil. Oh my gosh. I didn't even warm this up and it immediately was depositing color like perfectly. A lot of times with like a classic pencil, I find I have to warm it up on my hand to get a good creamy stroke and to get a good payoff on the color. Not the case. This immediately gave me the color payoff. The color is really good. This is a taupe shade, so it's not too warm. I feel like this is a really good, cool, neutral shade. If you're a blonde, you probably already know the last thing you want is an eyebrow pencil that makes your brows look orange. This is a really good shade. I went in very light right here at the inner part of the brow just because this really did have really good payoff. So I wanted to go in very light-handed so I could keep this portion a little bit lighter. Really like this brow pencil. I tend to like things that are a little bit pointier. I guess I could sharpen it up really good. So I'm not sure how often I'll reach for it, but if you like a classic eyebrow pencil, the kind you can sharpen, this is really nice. They did a really good job. Let's go in with bronzer next. This is the Eclat Soleil bronzing powder. I have the shade 01. I actually also own the shade 02, which matches me really well when I have a self tan, but right now, not gonna work. So right here we have 01 and right here we have 02. You can see there is a pretty clear difference in shade, my shade right now, but I might have a use for 02 in a moment. I'm just gonna take a pretty fluffy Real Techniques brush. We're gonna mix like drugstore brush with very luxury powder because the Real Techniques brushes, they are bomb.com. Do we still say bomb.com? I actually have recently been thinking about the song. If you guys remember, it came out when I was in 9th or 10th grade, so it would have been like 2004, 2005. There is a Bowling for Soup song called 1985, and it was all about a mom who, like, her kids tell her that she's uncool because she's still preoccupied with 1985. Literally, yes, I have it memorized, still thinking about it. And that song has been on my mind lately because I'm like, oh my god, like, am I now the mom from 1985? Like, I'm listening to like all of my favorite like pop hits on the Peloton doing my spin classes, and I'm listening to all the 2000s pop songs, and it's like, oh my gosh. When a song comes on the radio now, like, I don't even know them. The only current song that I know is Dua Lipa, the Levitating song, and I only know that song because there's a remix with DaBaby on it, and I only know DaBaby because he's from Charlotte, which is in North Carolina, where I'm from originally. I'm like, oh wow, I am now the old mom who like is like, wait a minute, I used to be young, you guys. Age, it comes up on you fast. Gonna bronze my nose up a little bit because I just need some color. It is summer. We're in June. Where has the time gone? I'm gonna take a fluffy brush. I already put some powder, and now I'm gonna take a fluffy brush and take a little bit of this bronzer in 01, and I'm gonna put that on my crease. This is a good trick to know that if you don't have eyeshadow, you can always use a bronzer if you have one. I actually love this. Oh my gosh, really pretty. I'm gonna take a little bit more of a dense brush and I'm gonna use the shade 02. I'm just gonna deepen up my crease a tiny bit. I'm gonna take a flat shader brush and I'm just gonna pack a little bit more of the very light powder onto my lid just to lighten it up a touch. I mean, come on, what? You guys, full disclosure, I literally, after trying some of this makeup the other day, I bought 2 Gucci belts because I decided, oh, I think I like Gucci now. I picked up 3 of the eyeliners. I got the black one, I got the chocolate one, and I got the Celeste, which is like the baby blue. I went ahead and swatched them on the back of my hand so you can see them. I really like them. I'm gonna go in with the chocolate first. I think I'm just gonna do a wing. I think that will accentuate this shape very nicely. I mean, that's like a barely there wing. And I only brought it to halfway point of my eye because I just kind of want to like elongate my eye a little bit. Loving where we're we're going with this. And then on the lower lash line, because I just want to do something fun, I'm going to take Celeste and I'm going to put that on the lower lash line. I'm not going to put it in my waterline. I want to go on the lash line. Or do I want to go on the waterline? Let's try the waterline. Know that blue generally makes things look more white, so I want to make the whites of my eyes look a little bit more white, and I kind of think I did it. I normally would smoke out my lower lash line, but I kind of want to leave it as like a baby lash line the way it is. Sometimes I like it when everything under here looks just like really bright, so I think I'm gonna leave it just as it is, and I'm gonna put a touch of mascara just on like the very like outer lower lashes of my eyes. With that mascara, what I did, I just did the outer lashes and I made sure to pull them out to the side so that we're keeping that angled look to the eyes. I really love that. My eye shape is pretty much almond, I believe, and I like to kind of play that up a little bit. I'm gonna go ahead and do my lips before I do cheeks. I have three of the satin lipsticks and I also have one of the Brilliant lipsticks. The Brilliant formula is their more glossy, a little bit more sheer formula, so I have that in the shade Call It a Day. And then in the satin lipstick, I have Terracina Ruby, Love Before Breakfast, and then May Coral, which is just a super popular shade. They're all kind of similar in the fact that they are a little bit on the cooler side. Let's go with May Coral. It is classic. So beautiful. I love that it's just like a bright pinky coral. I hear people talk about the shade all the time. It makes sense why. For cheeks, we're gonna try to like do something a little bit inventive. I'm gonna take a little bit of May Coral. I'm gonna put it on the back of my hand and I'm gonna mix in a little bit of the priming serum that we used at the beginning to try to kind of make my own like cream shadow. Let's try a sponge. Let's see if we can get something going with this. Guys, it's working. I'm interested to see how it wears throughout the day. Literally, my mom always used to tell me like, oh, you can just use your lipstick as your blush. So it's not the first time I have used lipstick as blush. It's just the first time that I have purposely done it and mixed it with a primer to, you know, try to make it work. But it's going swimmingly. Take a touch of it up here above my brow bone. That's just something that I really like to do. I feel like it pulls all the colors together. You guys, I am in love with this face of makeup. I almost don't even want to touch it, but we do have one more product to try that I'm actually like really curious about. This is the Éclat de Beauté Multi-Use Gel Gloss. Products like this really scare me. I'm always intrigued by them, but they really scare me because so often it's like, okay, is this going to pull up my makeup or what? You can see this literally looks like a jelly. It looks super gloss. Look at that gloss on my hands. I'm a little bit nervous about this, so I'm gonna put a little bit on the high points of my cheeks. I was 110% expecting this to just pull everything right up from under it. It is not doing that. Oh my God. That is so nice. Dang it, Gucci. I might have to go buy like a Gucci crossbody now. This is so nice. I just look glossy and just like, hello. Last but not least, I want to take a little bit of the powder again and just go over the places where I want to matte down a little bit so that we can truly appreciate the dimension that this gloss has given to this look. And wow, I'm just really, really impressed. I actually like the powder. It's nice. It feels very finely milled. It's not sticking to texture anywhere. It's setting everything really nicely. Kind of just doing what I expect a high-end powder to do. All right, guys, that's it for this full face of Gucci. If you like full face of one brand videos, be sure to check out the recent full face I did of Chanel and let me know in the comments below what full face of would you like to see next. I hope to see you in my next video, and until then, you take care of yourself. Bye.